And with that, Cassie the robot was off, making history by running 5 kilometers around the Oregon State University campus in just over 53 minutes on a single charge. It was a feat that had never been done before.
It's the first time a robot has learned to walk and run and successfully do that outside over kind of human terrain, normal terrain.
That's OSU robotics professor and founder of Agility Robotics, Jonathan Hurst. He and a team of engineers developed Cassie with the help of a $1 million grant from the U.S. Department of Defense. In fact, we were there inside the OSU Robotics Lab when Cassie was first being tested back in 2018.
It's a lot of fun.
At that time, it was a little tied up. But since then, the robot has made huge steps, graduating from being able to merely walk around the campus to now jogging.
It's not an in-the-lab kind of thing on a treadmill.
Hurst says someday the robots will be used in warehouses or for unloading delivery trucks, like you see in this mock ad for a fleet of autonomous vehicles from Ford. It was the first company to buy 2 of Agility's robots. Here you see the robot, this one called Digit, testing a package delivery service.
Makes it possible for you to get your packages in half a day and brings the cost down and provides us a really valuable service that everybody wants and needs.
Hurst says one day in the not-so-distant future, these robots could even help us in our daily activities.
And then over time, the robots are going to get better at interacting with people, at, you know, being as completely safe, can't possibly harm a person kinds of things. And then hopefully by the time I want or need it, start to help us age gracefully in our own homes, you know, and help us out around the house.
As for how much one of these robots might eventually cost, about $70,000, less than many cars. It will take some time, says Hurst, but it will be our future.
We're really out ahead of the pack, and we aim to stay there. So we're going to have to move fast and work hard.
Keeley Chalmers, KGW News.